ողջունենք ձեզ Cafesjian արվեստի կենտրոնում, հատուկ միջոցառումների սրահում։ Պետք է ասեմ, որ այս սրահը արդեն 3 տարի է, որ գործում է, եւ բոլոր միջոցառումները այստեղ տեղի ունեցել հատուկ հյուրերի համար։ Այնպես որ այսօր տեղի ունենում է հերթական միջոցառումը ձեր թանկագին ներկայությամբ, այսինքն դուք մեր այսօրվա հատուկ հյուրերն եք։ Միջոցառումը նվիրված է Զարթին։ Զարթին, որովհետև մենք կանայք բոլորս իհարկե մենք գեղեցիկ ենք, լավն ենք, ունենք գեղեցիկ հոգի, բայց ինչ որ բան երբեմն պակասում է եւ մենք այդ պակասը լրացնում ենք Զարթերի միջոցով։ Այսօր մենք ունենք հատուկ հյուր, հյուր Հոլանդիայից, որ շատ հայտնի է իր Զարթերի դիզայնով։ Իհարկե Մարգարիտը ինքը չի ստեղծում բնականաբար, բայց այն դիզայնը, այն գեղեցկությունը եւ այն հոգին, որ նա տալիս է Զարթը ստեղծելու ժամանակ, կներկայացնի շուտով։ Իսկ այժմ ձեր ծափահարությունների ներքո ուզում եմ հրավիրել նրան բեմ։ Fleur Klinkers, Հոլանդիա։
Բարի երեկո, սիրելի տիկնակ։ Welcome everybody, these dear ladies and some gentlemen.
Բարի կարոս, տիկնակ եմ պարանայք։
I'm very honored to be here tonight. And I hope I will tell you a lot of things about girls, and after my presentation, you can ask me as many questions you like.
So my song is Shapadrik Batman Zen Smaka in the Masi, and we present that to you.
As Christine already told you, my name is Fleur Klinkers, and I come from the Netherlands. My passion for pearls started, I don't know, already from when I was a small kid, but it was when I really started to creating with pearls was in something like 10 years ago. And at the moment, my passion for pearls is what I can see in every woman I look at. And a very important sentence for me and my business is, may love be your beauty and pearls be the recognition. Because love is a lot of beauty and we all like love. And pearls should be a mirror. When you wear these and you look at the pearls, you see yourself, your inner beauty, and you get recognition for yourself so you can shine. And so you can see who you are, who we are. Life is just wonderful, just the little things we see and we do. So I hope the pearls can give you a little remembrance to do so. I will first talk a little bit about myself, about my past, because before I went creating with pearls, I did a lot of different things. I have been traveling around the world for 1 year. I went to Singapore, Thailand, Malaysia, Asia, China, New Zealand, all different kind of countries I traveled to, and that gave me a freedom to see what there is all in the world. But when I came back, I realized where I've been born, these are my roots. And it is here where I want to create and to make my life. So I love traveling, I love motor riding, I love diving, I love drinking tea, I have nice cat at home, and I love skydiving. I don't do it anymore as much, but
ինչպես ասենք այս լայվից, ես ուզում եմ տարբեր բաներով զբաղվել, ուզում եմ թե խմել, դայվինգով զբաղվել, ունեմ կենդանի տատու.
And that is also so wonderful that I'm here in Armenia. I'm staying with Christine, and she is showing me how Armenia really is, and that's what I really, really like. I met Christine 1 year ago in the Netherlands in my shop, and she fell in love with my girls, and that's how everything started.
Ես հանդիպել եմ Քրիստինեին 1 տարի առաջ Նիդերլանդներում եւ ունացելերում խանութ, եւ նա սիրահարվեց իմ արքայիններին եւ այդտեղից սկսեց ամեն ինչ.
Now we will talk about a little bit more about the pearls, the history and how they exist and a lot of different things. So first of all, pearls are gifts from the gods. That's how it all started.
Իսկ հիմա մենք փոքր պատմենք մարքայինների պատմությունը. Մարքայինները դրանք պարգև են Աստծո կողմից.
There's a lot of girls gave these pearls to their daughters for their wedding or for different occasions. And for example, there is the meaning of the pearl. I will explain a little bit. That is, the pearl comes from the name perium, from the Latin, and it means the reflecting shape of gem.
Մարգարիտի նշանակությունը, մարգարիտը ծագման լատինական բառից է, այն նշանակում է թակարժի քարի ձևը.
And then the second one is the pearl is an universal messenger of immortality.
Եվ մարգարիտը աշխարհային ունիվերսալ նշանակությունը, որ նշանակում է անմահություն.
And pearls symbolize tears of life, and people really change that subject often. They think tears are for sadness, but I think when you don't have tears in your life, you can't be happy, you can't have any emotions. And it's really important to have tears, because then you can, yeah, you show your emotions, your feelings.
Եվ մարգարիտները դրանք կյանքի սկզբունքների և ուրախության արդյունքներն են, շատ հաճախ մարդիկ շփոթում են ասելով, որ մարգարիտները տխրության արդյունքներ են, բայց դա այնպես չէ.
When Venus came out of the water, out of the shell, I showed you earlier, the teardrops fell off her body and her hair into the water, and these drops turned into pearls when they came into the water.
Եվ մինարան ջրիտուս է գալիս, նրա մարմնից կաթում են արդյունքներ, ջրիկը կաթիններ, և այդ կաթինները թափվելով ջրի մեջ դառնում են մարգարիտներ.
The pearl is a stone for very many years, histories, thousands of years, or for status, wisdom, spirituality, fertility, a stone for the woman, for really feminine sides of life. It's also a stone of sincerity, innocency, beauty, love, purity, and perfection. It is just unique how it is. When it comes out of the water, it's just how it is. We can't do anything about it. It's just that stone. It's like we are. We are just how we are. And we should be happy for that. And then lots of poets use pearls as a metaphor in their poems for perfection of the beauty of the woman. Again, the beauty of the woman came back to it. But in history, also men used to wear it. Every month has a stone symbolizing that month, and the month of June is a pearl stone, a pearl. So when you're born in June, you should have a pearl. And then also songwriters use the theme pearls. For example, Prince used it for a song, Diamonds and Pearls lyrics.
Եվ շատ երկրորդներ ուղարվում են նաև մարգարիտները իրենց երկրի բարենի մեջ, որինակ մարգարիտներ և ադամանդներ երկրի բարերը։
There's a very famous story about a pearl and Cleopatra. It was Cleopatra's bet with Mark Antonio. There is the banquet of Cleopatra by Tipuli, and he always painted a lot of Renaissance types of paintings. But Cleopatra is of course an Egyptian queen. What was her bet about? She bet that she could spend a small fortune on a small meal. So what she did, she was wearing a pair of earrings. She took one of her earrings and she put it in a glass of vinegar. And vinegar is an acid, and this acid that dissolves the pearl. She took this vinegar and she drank it. And Antonio was totally surprised what she did, and she wanted to take a second earring and put it in the vinegar as well. But he said, no, you won already. It's good. So she not only won the bet of Mark Antonio, she also won his heart. So they're supposed to be married. And also a very important pearl is the peregrina pearl. This pearl was found by a slave in Egypt, and it was given by Cleopatra as well. And then it traveled to several queens in Europe. It first went to Spain, and it has a lot of history, that pearl. So far was the biggest pearl they ever had found, so it was huge. Les Taylor got this pearl by Richard Burton. He fell in love, they made a film together, and he fell in love with her, and he bought it at auction in 1967, and he gave it as a Valentine's present. Very nice. And now, then from that moment, she made a whole necklace of pearls and rubies, and yeah, make it even much more nice.
So
that was at the moment, it should be by Cartier for their 100th anniversary. It is already times ago, but the public the pearls at the heart of all religions, it was always there. They used it in crowns and mosaics everywhere. So these mosaics as well, they have used parlemor, so there's a part of the shell they use in these paintings, mosaics. And then Columbus, he traveled around the world, and one of his missions was to find pearls for the royal family of Spain. So a lot of royal family and high class people, they were pearls. It was a privilege. Also children, you see, you couldn't be wearing pearls when you are not rich. That was really to show off and to show that you have money. Also men wear warm pearls. This is in India, but also in Europe they used it a lot. So a lot of royal family gloves. There was even a story of there was a law in Venetia, also in England, that they were only allowed royal family to use and to wear pearls. When you would wear imitation pearls, you would get banned out of the city, and that was absolutely not allowed.
Եվ Վենետիկում և միայն Անգլիայում կար մի օրենք, որի ըստ որի միայն օրիգինալ մարգարիտներ պետք է գրեք, և եթե ինչ-որ մեկը գեղց մարգարիտներ գրում, նրան հրաշալի են քաղաքից։
And also to show that the pearls are very old use is that this mummy, they found this and there was also a lot of pearls around the hand of this mummy.
Եվ այսինքն ցույց տալիս, որ մարգարիտների օգտագործումը շատ հին ժամանակներից է սկսված։
And of course, the Dutch famous painting van Vermeer, the lady with the pearl, the girl with the pearl. And then, of course, a lot of crowns were used, pearls. And also a very nice thing is not many people know that, but pearls are made into powder. And you can use it on your face, and they say it is anti-aging. But it's really, you can buy it, and people in China they use it a lot. I will talk about Mikimoto later, but his wife. You use it every day of her life, she used pearl powder. Also, a lot of artists are fascinated about pearls. You see this pearl necklace in New York, but it's not a real pearl
necklace.
And then this is a bull made out of a lot of pearls. You make lamps out of it. I made one. Also, pearls disappear in paintings. This is a monkey, and the nose and the feet are all made of
parlamore.
They made fountains of it as well. This is one of my art pieces. It is a pearl, and I saw a turtle in it. So I made a turtle of it. I have also oil. And this is also a nice piece of art. It's all made of pearls. These are all pearls. And with gold, and then this was made of polymer shells. Also in the fashion, they use pearls, real pearls as well. So this is a little clutch. Yeah, I love pearls. I use them for everything. I use them here on my shoe. Like a little pearl lady itself. This was a dress it was worn by a known artist in Cannes, in the film festival. You have to light it, but they use it also on nails. Chanel, she's a famous pearl lover, and she uses it also in shoes. And again, this is not as an imitation pearl, but she also used it in hair.
սա օրիգինալ մարկարի չէ, բայց մարկարները նույնպես օգտագործվում են Բարսելոնայում։
It is not a real pearl, but the Institute of Gemology from America, they put it as a real pearl because it is really difficult to make the difference of a real pearl, and this is a pearl that came out of a clam.
Սա իրական բնական մարգարիտ չէ, բայց Ամերիկայի հանրակրկիտ հայտնի ինստիտուտը սա դասում է որպես մարգարիտների շարքին.
But this is the biggest pearl in the world, so it is found in the Palam Sea by the Philippines.
Սա ամենամեծ մարգարիտն է աշխարհում, գտնվում է Ֆիլիպիններում, Պալավան գոտում։
They call it also a pearl of Allah because it looks like the turbaned head of Allah.
Եվ սա նաև կոչվում են Ալլահի գլուխը, Ալլահի մարգարիտ, քանի որ հենց գլուխում նման է ինքը։
It is around 24 centimeters thick.
24 centimeter երկարությունն է, եւ 6.4 կիլոգրամ է կշռում։
And 6.5 kilo almost, and you can't believe that this is grown into a shelf in the sea somewhere. So this is not mother of pearl, but this they see it. They this signed by the Gemological Institute by this pearl. $42 million. You can see the how big it is, the ring and the big pearl next to it. This is the second largest, it's the same but a little bit smaller, so it's the same kind of pearl. The biggest pearl, the Tahiti pearl, is shown in Tahiti. The exact measurement is around this big. The exact measurements I couldn't find, so
I saw the Tahiti,
and of course a lot of pearls are worn by famous people like Diana. There's not only Diana who worn it, the whole royal family uses pearls. And she's wearing it on her dress here, and she loved pearls as well. But the royal family, for centuries, they're using pearls. And this is Coco Chanel. She loves pearls. She's very famous for it. She not always used real pearls, but she loves pearls at all. She said once that pearls are my favorite jewel. And why she said that? She said, when a man looks at me, he first looks at my person, and then he looks at my jewelry. While with diamonds, that's most of the time different. They look first at your diamonds, and then they look at you.
Մենք սիրով մարգարիտների հանդեպ, եւ նա շատ է օգտագործել մարգարիտները, ոչ միայն հիմնական, այլ նաեւ արհեստական, եւ նա մի անգամ ասել է, որ նա սիրում է մարգարիտները շատ, քանի որ իր հիմնական մարգարիտները տղամարդիկ սկզբից նայում են իրեն, հետո նոր իր գրած թանկարժեք քայլին, իսկ ադամանդների դեպքում միայն շոշոված ադամանդներն են նայում, հետո դեպքին։
And pearls are also used for many centuries to give from daughter to daughter. From one woman to daughter. It is a really nice and precious gift to give and to give to your children and to have a remember. Models wearing pearls, and this is a lot of different kind of pearls. Is the ones I really really love. I took most of it. I didn't take many round ones with me. I think it's only one necklace and bracelet with round ones. But I love the baroque shape because it is always different. This is also very famous. It's also pearls. They used a lot of for photo shoots, and old and modern men. They use pearls as just an icon. And this is well also for photo shoots. It's amazing what you can all do with it. And Michelle Obama, of course, in America. And Jackie O'Kennedy, love pearls as well. I have a little story about that as well. Once she got an imitation pearl, she got a real pearl. It was made of, it was nice, but it's plastic. And when she went for auction, it costed, I think, $60, and it went for auction for, I don't know at the top of my head, but I think it was like around $1 million they sold it for.
Այս ժամանակ գաջեն քնեզի մնացել է մարկայիտ, բայց գերսը պլաստիկ է եղել դա, որը նա գնել է $60, բայց ակցիոն ժամանակ
$1,600. And Federico Fellini, a famous film director, he said once, all art is autobiographical. The pearl is the oyster's autobiography. And it's a very nice thing. I always say, like, the pearl is an art on itself, because the oyster or the mussel makes it, and you never know how it looks like. You don't have influence on how it looks, a little bit maybe today, but not as much. It is always how the oyster or the mussel wants to be. So it's a piece of art on its own. And of course, there is an island, Isla Margarita, the pearl of the Caribbean, is called, and the name Margarita comes in all languages. Is it famous? So you have it, for example, in ancient times, it was a holy name, Margarita or Margaret. And I will give you a few in Italy. They use it, Margarita or Rita. It's also from the pearl. In French, Marguerite or Margot, in German, Margarete, Gretchen, Gretel, and in English, Margaret, Marjorie, Madge, and Margie, but in Armenian, I heard they have also Margaret, and my mom's name is Margaret, so it's really typical. And also for men, it is also used, so Garrett or Garrett, I don't know what Armenian, do they have? In all religions, the pearl comes back, and that it is a holy, holy stone. And they say this was a gift from Jesus. The pearl is really related with Jesus, and with a lot of difference in Muslim religion and different religions. The pearl is always a very, it's mentioned in the Bible or in all the religious books. Okay, now I will talk about a little bit more about the pearls. There are many different kinds of pearls. So you have small ones, big ones, nice ones, ugly ones. So they're all different, and they're made out of some pearls grow into the shell, otherwise they grow into the flesh of the oyster or the mussel. These are natural colors of the, so they come out of the oyster, how they look like this, so they're not colored, they're just like that. And the different kind, this is a natural pearl, and there's no human interruption. It is really made by nature. I will show you a film later, and there's all explained how it exists and how it, These are snail pearls and they are very rare. And we have the Apoya pearls and they come mainly out of Japan. And South Sea pearls, they are grown into oysters. So salt sea water pearls, they are grown in oysters, and oysters they are smaller and I can grow maybe 1, 2, maximum 3 or 4 in one oyster. And the smallest around 8 millimeters, and the biggest can be 21 millimeters, but that's very, very big. Normally it's 18. And then we have the cashew pearls. Cashew pearls, they grow also, but they are very different shapes. Different shapes, not round or. Yeah, these are, for example, cashew pearls. They're mostly flat, they can be also a little round, but mostly flat. The Tahiti and Awaiki pearls. Tahiti is they found in the Polynesian Tahiti. Awaiki they come from the Cook Islands. The Tahiti pearls are very, they made it very commercial. The Awaiki and they're very shiny. They go really for shyness. Just how more shine on the pearl, how better the pearl is. The Awaiki pearls. They have more oriental look, so they don't shine as much, but they have more, yeah, I think more natural look. Then we have the maid pearls. Maid pearls, they are found into the mussel itself, in the shelf. And what they do with it, they cut it out, they saw it out and they make pendants out of it or other different things. And you have blister pearls. Blister pearls are little, small little pearls in the shells. And then we have the freshwater pearls. Freshwater pearls, they come in a lot of different kind of shapes. So you have heart shape, flower shape, square, round. Mostly they are smaller, and it is really difficult to get big ones. And they're experimenting at the moment with big ones. For example, these are also freshwater pearls, and this is really unusual to get such big ones, but what they do, I will explain you also later, they put like a bigger round nucleus in it, and the mussel finds that a little bit weird, and then he goes, makes really strange, nice little art pieces. And then we have the imitation pearls. They're not real pearls, but to mention, they are still really nice imitation pearls. And for example, the Mallorca pearls, people really know, and they are made from different things, but they're totally handmade, so they're not worn into the sea or any different, but made by an oyster, they're handmade. So the pearl of the pearl, how does a pearl exist? So the pearl is grown into the flesh of the mussel or the oyster. So so sea pearls are grown into oysters, freshwater pearls are grown into mussels. And the film you will say, let's see later how a pearl will exist, but how it really starts is like a little interruption comes into this oyster and in this mussel, and then he goes and forms all kind of layers of polymer around it, and that is how the pearl exists. So a lot of layers are formed around the interruption because she doesn't like that the that there is something in there. He made a technique how we can help nature a little bit more to get a pearl. A pearl is a living jewel, and that is really true because it is made by a living creature, the mussel or the oyster, and it's a really natural and living organism all itself. They still don't know exactly how the pearl exists. But Mikimoto created a way how we can make it faster to get a bigger pearl, because normally when you find a pearl in the wild, you need 15,000 oysters to open to get one natural pearl. That's also why they're so expensive, but it's also not good for nature. There are wars about pearls, lagoons where really a lot of oysters were taken out to get a pearl because it was just such a treasure thing, and it was just not good for nature. They killed all these animals, they killed the sea life, it was just not good. This is a really good thing what Mikimoto did, and I will explain you how it worked. So what he did is he made a nucleus made of shelves, pressed shelves in different ways. Different farm companies do it in a different way, but it must be natural. And he put a little bit of flesh of another oyster, they put it together inside in an oyster or a mussel, and then it will adapt and it will come a lot of layers of polymer around it. Yeah, you can see this is, for example, a freshwater pearl, and they made a really huge, big nucleus, and and that is what it became. So you can see inside a little bit, there's still the nucleus, and the pearl just becomes, But every pearl, like my ring as well, there's always difference, and it makes only the round bit that is really what we put in, and all the rest is all like natural, created by the muscle.
Եվ այս կոնկրետ այս մատանին ես գլոր հատվածի միջուկեր օրինտավատվում այն, եվ հրաշուրջը աթեն տարբեր ձևերով ձևավորվում է մարկարիտը։
So you have different many shapes of, you can make more like flat shapes in there, so you get this, but all the top is all natural, only here in the middle it's something put in there, so they're always different shapes.
Եվ այստեղ տարբեր ձևեր են տեսնում եք, կարող են տափա, կարող են գլոր ունեն, միջուկի հատված այդպես կլոր երևում է, բայց շարունակությունը արդեն ամբողջը բնական է։
Some sea pearls are neck colored, and freshwater pearls they color a lot. But the color goes really inside the whole pearl, so it's not only on the outside. And here you can see it very good. The color goes really totally into the pearl.
Եվ ամեջրերի մարկայինները չեն ունավորվում, բայց կաղսահան ջրերին է ունավորվում են, երբ հենց մջուկիցած տեսում են ունավորվում են ամբողջությամբ ունավորվում են.
And the nice thing about it as well is it always takes the surroundings. When you're wearing pearls, it always fits. It fits really everybody. It is just when you're wearing white and you're wearing pearls, the colors adapt and they always combine really nicely.
Եվ մակայների մասին ամենալավ բանն այն է, որ կապչուղին չի խախտվում և ով եք այն գրում, միշտ ծավալվում է, կարող եք սրշոտ ամբներ և սպիտակ մարկային տշան հեղոցիվ նաև է, միշտ ադապտացվում է։
Here you see also the outside layer, how much polymer is around the pearl, and that's also how much shine, how much color, and the quality of it is also rated by that.
Եվ այստեղ տեսնում եք միջուկ են համատած բեին շերտը և աստրան ենպես աթեն որոշում է մակայատիքները։
And these are some pictures about the pearl farms. This is in Tahiti. And you can see how big a mussel can be. It is huge. It can be sometimes 1 meter.
So big.
Can be one mussel.
Tahiti-ում այստեղ հատկան տեսնում եք շատ մեծը։
And here you can see that they put like this nucleus into the oyster. You will see that on the film later as well. Also, the people who put these nucleus inside the oyster needs to be really careful. They can open it only a little bit because otherwise the muscles will break and they will die.
Եվ տեղադրում ժամանակ պետք է շատ զգուշ լինել, փոքր լացումի և տեղադրում, այնապես կարող են վնասել մկանը և տեղադրել մկանը։
Of course, there are mussels and oysters that die with this human life as well. So then they use the flesh of these animals and they use to put it with that nucleus.
Եվ երբեմն նաև մսենապտանոցում ու միջոք է տեղադրում ժամանակ։
Then you have different qualities of pearls. They raise them up, different things, and there's always difference. And I sometimes don't understand why that one costs so much and that one costs so much. It's just like the pearl farms rate it itself, and the at auction all pearls are sold by auctions by other big dealers. They make jewelry out of it, and the prices are always different. But these are the main qualities. That they are rated
of.
So the shape is really important. How more round, how more expensive. It is, of course, how more perfect the pearl is, how more expensive it is. And then the color. The darker colors are more in Tahiti than the darker South Sea pearls. They are more expensive than the lighter ones. But it is pure a question of taste. It's when you like lighter colors or darker colors, and now it is just a taste. You shouldn't rate on what it costs, you should just go for what you like, because that is important. You have to wear what you like and not what someone else is like, or it is expensive or not expensive. When you like it, that's the most important thing, because then you also will wear it.
Եվ դահիտի մարկայինները դրանք հիմնականում շատ ավելի մոգ են, և ասում է մարկայինը ավելի թանկարժ է, բայց մարկայինը մի ժամանակ չպետք է մտածես, թե ուրիշները ինչ են ասում, այլ պետք է գնես այն, ինչ քեզ է դուր գալիս, և քանի որ դու ես հագնելու, պետք է քեզ դուր գա, բայց դա դահիտի մարկայինը ինձ կարծիքով ավելի մոգ է
կարելի նայել. Then the shine is really important. I think that's important as well. That's why I always look at. That's for me the most important thing. The shine is, or the parlor more than what is around it. That is a really nice fluster, they call it. And there are a lot of characters in there as well. You can have some, yeah, they call it comments. There can be like little buts in there as well, so a little bit stripes can be there, but that's natural. That's just how it is, and yeah, that is a natural thing. So it is not that the scratch, because pearls can't really get scratched, but it's just a natural phenomenon.
Այն ընդհանուր շարժումներ են կան, մարկայինը չի կարող ծանոթանալ մաքրինը, կարող են ինչ-որ գծեր ունենալ դրա վրա, նույնպես դա առանձնահատկություն ունի մարկայինը.
And the thickness of the layer I showed you earlier, that's important. And I think that's really important, because when you wear pearls, when you wear it, for example, every day for 20 years, your pearl will get smaller. Your body gets it, takes it, and that's also a good thing, because the pearl is a good for your body.
Եվ մարկայինի հաստությունը նույնպես շատ կարևոր է, եթե մարկայինը երկար տարիներ գնում է, սկսում է 20 տարի, մարկայինը գոմատնում է, անդրացում է, և ընկնելով մարկայինը փոքրանում է, և հաստ մարկայինը է, հանավերին է.
So you should really wear pearls, that is really important. Don't put them in dark cases. It is a living thing, it has to breathe, it needs air.
Եվ մարկայինը մարդոր պարսում է համար է լավ, պետք է գրել այն, այն ոչ թե արկղերի մեջ պահել, հանում ու ասում է այն մարկայինը սիմ է ապվել, պետք է շնչի։
And that's the same with human beings, we need air as well.
Եվ ինչպես մարկայինը այնպես է մարդը, կարծես կենթանի օրգանիզմ պետք է շնչի և օդի ապվել։
Yeah, I have told the pearls are the only gemstones growing inside a living organism. That I have told you that already. That is. These are eFKAY pearls. They still have shine, but there's a different orient of than Tahiti pearls on it. I have some Tahiti pearls with me, and also some eFKAY pearls. So if you want to see the difference.
Այստեղ ավայքի մարկայի ցուցադրված մի փոքր փայլում է, բայց Թայթիի նման չի փայլ, այստեղ ցուցադրված են երկու տեսակը, կարող են նաև
համատուցել. These are the different colors of Tahiti pearls, so they come in different kinds. There are also lighter ones, these are just a few of them, but these are the main ones and the most famous ones, but there are also lighter ones. I have here also a Tahiti pearl, and that is much lighter.
Այստեղ արդեն միներ են ցուցադրված Տահիտի և ավայքի մարկայինների տեսակների, լինում են բաց գույների, ավելի մուգ գույների, այստեղ արդեն ցուցադրված են գույները։
So also again, that is taste. You like it or you don't like it or you...
Բայց ինչպես արդեն ասված, դա արդեն կապված է մարդու ճաշակից, բաց գույները սիրում կամ կսիրում արդեն մի ճաշակի հարց է։
And Tahiti and Abiki pearls get rated. They all get a rate. You will see that in the film later as well. But what quality it is. It is also not allowed to that bad pearls go out of the country of Tahiti. They just get they get rid of it. They make powder out of it.
Եվ Տահիտի և ավայքի մարկայինները գնահատվում են, և Տահիտում ընդունված չէ բարդ մարկայինները պահել և աճարքի հանել, բարդ մարկայինները գնահատվում են.
So they only want to sell the best. These are some photographs of pearl farms. Also, it's really important how they take the oyster. They can't go with bottles of air in the sea. They can only go with their own lungs.
Australian country.
It is really all ecological. It is not. It's really important for to grow, to let the pearl grow. They need a lot of clean seas. That is really important as well. That's why they get washed quite a lot, so they get a lot of showers. So these are some nice people from Tahiti and the people who farm as well. And Robert One has the only pearl museum in the world. And
Robert One has a museum in the
dedicated to pearls, of course. He has a private collection, a really nice one. He has the biggest Tahiti pearl as well. Robert One is a designer. He has a lot of islands around Tahiti. He owns these, and he sells designs and sells pearls to jewelers and around the whole world. He's really famous. Like me, like he loves pearls, but he loves the Tahiti pearls. I like the bamboo shaped pearls. So you will find out the history of the pearls throughout the whole world, and the large Tahiti pearl I told already. And then I want to talk a little bit more about freshwater pearls, the pearls I use as well. I use these as more because the shapes are much more different and unique. You get long shaped ones, you can drill them in different ways, so you get also different designs in your jewelry. This is I make jewelry for all ages, and this is a bracelet I made for babies, for children, and you can see here the flower shape. This is a pearl, and this is also a heart shaped pearl, and it's really nice. They just put a little heart inside the muscle on a little flower, and then the muscle goes and makes then a nice polymer layer around it. Then you also have the baroque shape. This is color brown freshwater pearls. The green ones. It's really what is nice. You can show it here later. This is the green one. The pearls are colored, but they're still different in color. There's not one color. It's not painted. It is really true and true, and it looks really. It still looks really, really natural. It is natural. Only the color is made all different. Yeah, this coin shape. It's like looks like a coin, and they put like a coin shape into the muscle.
Yes, I think copeket is one. The
white color is natural, but most of the time they dye it for some reason. On the top as well, again these longer ones, and then you have these ones are little crosses. And it looks really fun when you have a necklace with that as well. I have one, not with me. So you can make a lot of nice creations with freshwater pearls, and also the price is a little bit lower than South Sea pearls. A very important thing is how you treat pearls, the maintenance of pearls. You should wear pearls as many times, as often as you can. The degrees of our body will give more shyness to the pearl. It protects us now. Never use acids like hairsprays, perfume, cosmetics. They are really, really bad. When you go to the hairdresser, take your pearls off because they really don't like that. You can see that with the pearl from Cleopatra, it just dissolves and you get these. Just doesn't look nice anymore after a few years.
Yes, it's a lot of people who are in the market. I'm not quite a lot of money. I'm not sure if I'm not sure if I'm not sure if I'm
A lot of my clients say when they wear pearls, they get always a lot of compliments, and that's always nice to hear for me, but also for the clients, because then they will wear it even more. And it's just also when you wear pearls, you get a different feeling, because it is natural, it is something unique, it is nobody has the same, because it is always different. So treasure your pearls.
But in the late 19th and beginning of the 20th century, Japanese researchers discovered a new method for artificial production of pearls. Essentially, this technique comprehends the positioning of a foreign body into the flesh of the shell. Then the arranged shell is abandoned to the sea again to wait for the natural development of a hopefully gorgeous pearl. Kokichi Mikimoto deserves the honor having perfected this technique of artificial stimulation for the development of round pearls and oysters. In 1916, he therefore was awarded a patent. Mikimoto's discovery allowed that pearls could be cultivated like economic plants and opened the doors for the expanded growth of the pearl industry. Since then, cultured pearls could be produced in adequate quantities. Now any of their admirers are free to adorn themselves with it. Every year, the worldwide commercial value of cultured pearls exceeds $500 million by far. In the following reports, we would like to transport you to the fascinating world of pearls, explain their history, show you the mystical breeding of pearl oysters, and give you useful tips around the topic pearls.
And I would like to give you something as well. I made something specially for this museum, for Armenia. So I'd like to present this this piece. It's made of silver, knitted, all the little pearls knitted with it, so freshwater pearls. to have a, I call it pearl d'amour, because pearls are full of love.
Անվեր պատրաստված է ամբողջությամբ մարգարիտներից եւ արծաթից է հյուսված է արծաթները եւ նրան հնացված է մարգարիտները։
Thank you very much. We really appreciate that and your wonderful presentation. And your works are really wonderful. And I hope the Armenian people will like it, will appreciate it. And I'll say this in Armenian. Արգելի հյուրեր, նշեմ, որ Կաֆեսյան արվեստի կենտրոնը դառնում է տարածաշրջանում միակ ներկայացուցիչը այս հրաշալի զարդերենի։ Եվ կարող եք ձեռք բերել մեր թանգարանի խանութում, որտեղը բոլորդ գիտեք առաջի արկում, պատկերասրահի միջում։
This beautiful collection is being displayed in Cafesjian Center for the Arts in the museum store, so you can come select your beautiful scooter, please.
Again, thank you very much for your wonderful gift and for the wonderful evening that you presented to all our guests tonight. Հաճելի հյուրասիրություն, խնդրեմ համեցեք մեր աստղերի հարթակ Սարոսկի բյուրեղապահ ցուցադրությունում, մտքերը կիսեք ու վերասիրեք։ Շնորհակալություն։